2 days into D23, we got some great news. Ms. Marvel, She-Hulk, Moon Knight will be added to Phase 4 of the Disney Plus streaming service. These are happening at the end of the phase, 2021. Good news to know that it won't be such a short phase. Now, with putting these on the streaming services, instead of putting these on the theaters, it's less of a demand. It's easier to put it over here. When you're trying to sell a movie, trying to get someone out their bum into the theaters for a character we never heard of, a character we never heard of, and a she character we never heard of. Like, it's much more easier to put that stuff on streaming. Hey, you already have it for the big stuff we mentioned earlier, like Wanda, who everyone's familiar with, like Loki, who's everyone's familiar with, Hawkeye. Now stick around for Kamala Khan, the Jersey City Pakistani 15-year-old. It's like that a movie that's ambitious. I know Marvel takes risks and they're doing an Eternals movie, and yeah, but at least they're like super. Ms. Marvel is just, she can stretch her body, change. She writes fan fiction. She's like that. She's unique. I can't even compare her to something. I could compare her to Mr. Fantastic and Mystique and Ant-Man because she can get bigger and smaller. But other than that, she's unique because she's advertised as the first Muslim American comic book character to hit the big screen. I know there have been others in Marvel, but none as big as Ms. Marvel, who like is a title character of her own series. She is that. Is that a draw? Remains to be seen, like fossils in a museum. I don't think the Muslim community is out here looking for representation, the oh-so-valuable representation in our cinemas, because we want our kids to grow up to be like superheroes. That's like, there's so much that's impermissible in movie culture and all that. Like, that is a contradictory to the Islamic belief. It's like, no one's out here looking for, yeah, we need some Ms. Marvel. Like, that's that community is not gonna show out the same way any other community would if that's what Marvel's looking for. But again, it's happening on Disney Plus, their TV series. She-Hulk is gonna be interesting. I don't know much about this character, but I do know that she is on the Avengers team, the 2018 and 19 Avengers team. So is Blade. They added him recently. And then this news comes out that Blade's getting a movie and that She-Hulk is getting is it a web series? It's called a web series. Interesting, right? It's nice to see them coordinated, comic book world and the whatever Ike Perlmutter owns. It's nice. Now, who's over here? The goddamn X-Men, Cyclops, Jean Grey, Professor X, Magneto, and Wolverine, bub. They haven't said a thing about these guys. It's Sunday, and they, you know, they could still say something about the FF and these guys, but there's no, like, Phase 5 noise. So the closest we got to Phase 5, back to the side, is my boy Black Panther, who I hope you can see on the screen. He is getting his movie in May, not in February anymore. They're like, okay, big franchise guy, $1.3 billion. You're getting that summer movie release, buddy, and it's going to be a hit. I'm happy to know that they're respecting him. And they wouldn't say a thing, which they shouldn't, about his... They said, should we talk about his villain, Ryan Coogler? No, we're not going to let him know about that. They asked him, should we talk about what the movie subtitle will be called? It's not going to be Black Panther 2. It'll be, you know, Doom War or Black Panther. I hope it is Doom War. Maybe Doom War should be the third one, actually. Just build some aggressive, build some, like, hatred happening amongst the people of Wakanda. Like, yo, why we open the borders to these people? This isn't right. I can't believe what happened to Wakabi. And build that angst in the next movie while... You know, while Black Panther is out here looking for a wife and he meets Aurora Monroe. Hey, don't I remember you from my excursion? Yeah, when you were in Kenya. Oh, wow. And he freezes, literally freezes, because Aurora can make things cold. Let's do something like that with Black Panther. And then the people of Wakanda, the kind of nationalists, will hate him and say, well, Dora Milaje weren't good enough for him? The Dora Milaje translates to the adorned ones. They're supposed to be when Christopher Priest was writing the comic. They were supposed to be candidates for him to marry. And he went with Storm, and then they divorced because of Namor. So maybe the villain is Namor in this one? Who knows? I think this movie is probably the most I'm interested in since that they've announced, officially that they've announced. Thor Love and Thunder. Not, I should keep this poster behind me more often. This is useful. Thor Love and Thunder. I mean, Marvel's never put out a bad movie, okay? Now, it's based off Jason Aaron's. I have no idea what they'll do other than Jane Foster will become worthy. Is there a Mjolnir in the universe? Not since Endgame. But Captain America forged the shield out of nowhere and gave it to Sam Wilson. Maybe he visits Thor and says, hey, I don't need this anymore. Gives him a Mjolnir. It's a comic book movie. Anything is possible. But, like, I'm not too thrilled. But I'll like it. No, all it takes is a good trailer to convince me. Ghost Rider's getting a Hulu. Captain Marvel's got nothing announced. Iron Man is dead. That's America's ass. Chillmonger is the name on the channel. You can subscribe by clicking on that thing there. I will do more comic reviews. Iron Man had a good comic book this week. I'll probably review that. And then Ms. Marvel had a comic, which I'll review also.